Hey y'all, it's Costa. I help people break the system to build a better future. Today, we're talking about the Delta variant of COVID-19 and why it's critical to take every step you can to keep yourself and those around you healthy. Working with the aging, chronically ill, and disabled population for the past decade, I want to help you understand that long-term care isn't an inevitability, and we all have the responsibility to protect ourselves and others from one of the most harmful, deadly, and contagious airborne diseases we've experienced in our lifetimes. Where did the Delta variant come from? All viruses will change through mutations, and this is inevitable. Sometimes the variants are gone as quickly as they come, and sometimes they can stick around for a long time. With the unpredictability and aggression of variants, they can be difficult to stop and nearly impossible to keep contained. The difference in virus variants can be tracked through physical characteristics or changes in the genetic code. Scientists have been working around the clock, studying the virus and its mutations to help determine which one is most dangerous and strategize containment and treatment. If you want to see more information on the Delta variant, or any of the other variants of the highest concern in the United States, visit cdc.gov/coronavirus. So what do we know about the Delta variant? Well, we know that it is highly transmissible. In fact, it has been shown to be 2 times more contagious than any other variant or version of COVID-19. The Delta variant is currently the most common strain of virus in the United States. And data from cases of the Delta variant show that this strain could have much more severe side effects than the original COVID-19 virus in people who are unvaccinated against the virus. While vaccinated individuals can still contract and spread COVID-19, the side effects of the virus are weakened and the transmission rate is a shorter amount of time. The Delta variant also has been shown to attack younger people with a shorter incubation period and more powerful symptoms than the novel coronavirus. So this comes as a surprise, as they were a low-risk group with the exception of those with a compromised immune system. The highest risk groups as of right now are those who are not vaccinated and our older/immunocompromised population. While those who are vaccinated can still contract COVID and spread it, it is not as severe as it would be for someone unvaccinated. What can we do to stop the spread of all variants of the novel coronavirus? As of late summer 2021, the CDC has reinstated mask mandates, understanding the spread of both the novel COVID-19 virus and the Delta variant are spreading at a rate unsustainable for our health system, our public health, and the well-being of all Americans. Especially with most schools returning to in-person learning, it will be easy for children to transmit the virus amongst each other and ultimately bring it home to family members. Maintaining social distancing guidelines and reducing the number of people you interact with in closed spaces can also help keep you healthy and reduce the likelihood of other variants developing. So getting vaccinated is the best place to start. If you aren't already vaccinated and you live in the United States, I urge you to talk with a medical professional and get vaccinated as soon as possible. The vaccine is proven safe and effective and is completely free to get. While the vaccine is not a miracle elixir, it has been proven to lessen the severity of the virus and can reduce the risk of you spreading it to a loved one. Finally, with different variants on the rise and vaccination rates remaining low, hospital staff are responding with the reality of it all. At the time of this recording, many of the healthcare systems in cities and states are completely full or operating with less than a 5% capacity for care. Guys, get vaccinated, wear a mask, and self-isolate whenever necessary. This virus isn't going away on its own. The time to act is now, and our situation can and will continue to worsen if we don't take personal responsibility to end this pandemic and stop the further spread of COVID-19 and the Delta variant.